start with some review. First of all, how many pieces of pizza are there?
Eight.
So let's say someone ate one piece of pizza. What would be the fraction for that? Okay, so what about, let's say a couple hours later, that same person went and ate another piece. What would just that fraction be? Still out of eight.
Two pieces.
No. One piece of pizza.
Wouldn't it be one of eight?
Yeah, it'd be one of eight, because I said still out of eight. So what would adding these together, if they have like denominators, you just add the top. So what would be the total amount of pizza that they ate?
Two eights.
Yeah. So now we're going to do adding fractions with unlike denominators. So going back to the pizza, how much pizza would a person have eaten if they ate half a pizza? So out of
four.
Okay. Can that be reduced? So what?
Two-fourths.
Just gonna ask. Okay. So going from one half, what if they ate one more piece? What would that fraction out of eight be?
Five out of eight.
Yeah. Okay. This is not working. So one. So eight pieces. One out of one piece, even though they ate half, what would just that fraction?
One piece out of the half?
One piece out of the whole.
1/8.
Yeah. You want to eat. So what happens if you add 1/2 plus 1/8? And this is where the unlike denominators come into play.
The 5/8.
How'd you get there?
1/2 is 4/8, so 4 plus 1 is 5.
Yep. Yeah, that's an 8. Yep. Okay, so we're going to do some more examples that won't be as. So 3/4 plus 1/5. So can you add these based on the denominator? So
when they bring their notebooks.
So what you need to do is find a common denominator, which is something that both 4 and 5 will go into. Anyone have an idea?
20.
Hmm?
20.
Yeah, be 20. So what do you have to multiply by to get multiply 4 by to get 20?
5.
So multiply that by 5. Now with fractions, whatever you do at the bottom, you have to do the top. So in this case, you would have to multiply the 3 by what? And then, what do you have to multiply 5 by to get 20?
4.
And then what do you multiply the top by?
4.
So what would be 3? What's 3 times 5?
15.
And then we already established this is 20. And then you add what's 1 times 4? Where do you have an idea?
4.
Yep. And then this would be 20. Now all you have to do is add the numerators since the denominators are both the same. Anyone want to add 15 plus 4? 4?
19/20.
Yep. Good job. All right, are there any questions so far? Okay. So anyone want to try this one? Megan, you want to come up to the board? Can you explain what you're doing while you're doing it? If not, we can just go over it at the end.
More common.
The denominator
would be 18. So to get this to 18, you have to multiply it by 2.
Yep.
And so the same at the top. And then to get this to 18, you have to multiply it by 9. So 18. 23 times 2 is 46.
Yep.
And 5 times 9 is
45.
Yep. All she did was figured out that 18 goes into both, or you multiply the two and you get 18, and that's the lowest common factor.
And then one more.
This one is easy at first, but then at the end we're gonna do something a little different. So can someone tell me what's the lowest common factor between 8 and 10? Both numbers can go into it.
2.
Okay, so you divide by 2, but if you have to multiply them to get the same answer.
80.
Okay, so your common denominator would be 80 for both of these. What do you have to multiply 8 by to get 80? So what's 5 times 10?
50.
And what do you have to multiply 10 by to get 80?
8.
Yep. So what's 8 times 3?
24.
And then now, since we have the common denominators, now you all have, now you have to add the numerators.
Megan?
7, 4, 3.
Alright, now can that be reduced?
Mm-hmm.
What can it be reduced by?
2.
So how would you reduce this?
Divide both of them by 2.
So can someone give me that answer? 74 divided by 2?
37.
And then 80 divided by 2? Now, 80 is a common factor, but there's a smaller one that you guys could have said too. Does anyone know what that is?
40.
Yeah. So how would you do the common denominator of 40? What do you have to multiply 8 by to get 40?
5.
Yeah. Just cross those out. So what's 5 times 5?
25.
And then what do you have to multiply 10 by to get 40?
4.
So what's 3 times 4?
12.
Okay, so I want to add 25 and 12?
37.
So you can see that even though 80 is still correct, as long as you reduce, you still get the same answer. Any questions?